Este video llega a ustedes gracias a nuestros patrones.
Especialmente Edgar, Belky, Jason y Emilio.
¡Minyao TV!
¡Hola, Minionatics!
Bienvenidos a
¡Minyao TV!
Yo soy Sol.
Y yo soy Luna. Hoy es viernes.
¡Viernes de video!
¡Yay! Señores, today, that is Friday, we're gonna be reacting to something beautiful. Someone beautiful.
Yeah, they already seen the title, so
okay, guys, yeah, it's true. You guys already know that we are reacting to Rubí y Amateo full performance in Miss
Philippines Universe.
Miss Universe Philippines or whatever.
2020,
guys, this is a video that has been requested by you.
Highly requested.
I hope that a lot of people is watching this video, or otherwise I'm going to haunt your dreams. You don't even imagine what I will do.
Oh my god, remember that recently they got struck by a super typhoon, so
it's true. Let's just
so maybe now everybody is gonna be watching, because now everybody who watches Minyao TV has electricity or something.
Okay, I will spare you guys.
Spare them this time.
For now.
Soon on our channel, we're gonna be reacting to the performance of SB19 of Ikako in Philcore Fest 2020, together with various other artists. So don't miss it. Please subscribe to this channel.
Remember, at 20k subs, we are going to show you this set. We have a set tour at 20k subscribers.
Yes.
If you want to be part of history and be the one who got us to get to 20k subs, you have to subscribe now.
Right now.
Click the button down below right now. And now let's just react to this video.
Yes.
Oh my god. Rubia Mateo.
Oh, Rabia.
Ah, Rabia. Iloilo. Excuse me. How do you pronounce Iloilo?
Iloilo City.
But maybe this person, as he's obviously not Filipino, doesn't know how to pronounce.
You don't know if he's Filipino or not. Why are you so quick to judge? He could be a Filipino. Why not? Wow, she is so
gorgeous,
beautiful.
She's gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous.
And her charisma too. Wow, the quality of this video is not helping us.
Yeah, it's not helping at all.
Miss Iloilo City, Miss Rabia Mateo, how are you?
I'm doing great. I feel like I'm one step closer from having my first national crown.
Well, you are actually. You are in the top 16. So let's see how it goes with this
question.
This comment here. You have 30 seconds to answer this. Mm. Throughout this journey, you have discovered that you are a phenomenal woman who is conditioned for greater. How can you create a positive and lasting impact to the world around you? Your time starts now.
That's a very difficult question. Oh my god. Because
they are trained to reply to this kind of question.
You had to be humble, but also you had to talk about all the awesome things that you can do. You know, like, how do you answer this without sounding like you're bragging about all your skills?
Or...
and sounding like you want a better place and that you are humble. Like, this is difficult to me.
In my case, I would say that I am very...
Oh my god, I'm nervous! Miss Dominica, Republic Universe, okay.
Well, I am very inclined to work with the future generations. That's why I intend to be part of a foundation that works. It's una fundación, it's a charity that it says in English. But with a charity that involves helping kids to grow and discover their potential.
Oh my god, I'm not gonna win.
let's see what Rabia Mateo says.
First of all, I need to stick to my core, which is being passionate about educating people. Ooh. I am a lecturer, and I've been pursuing this because this education had helped me to have that comfortable life that I and my family deserves. And I want to push people. I want them achieve greater things in life through me. And I know with Miss Universe, anything is possible because I am a phenomenal woman with a heart of beauty.
Wait, that doesn't sound humble. Oh my God.
Well, but she wants to educate.
Yeah.
Works in education. Well, there you go.
Like, you can do this. You can achieve better things. But then she added, through me. And I'm like, okay.
No.
Sounded like she was
right. Let's continue.
But
oh,
this is a very difficult question, so I understand.
The swimsuit competition.
She has legs. 4 days, my friend.
Yes. Oh my God.
Wow, she's so beautiful.
Whoa.
Wow. Her smile is everything.
Yes.
And how she moves her hips from one side to the other side is like, she's walking, but she's dancing at the same time. Let's repeat that. Look.
She knows what she's doing. That's why she's smiling like
the evening gown competition.
Oh, she wore red, burgundy red. Wow.
Wow. John Candelaria designed this. I like the cape. Wow, this dress is gorgeous.
That's awesome.
It's very suitable for her body type.
The top 5 announcement.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, did you see? Wait, did you see the one from Cavite next to her? She's a very popular one too.
Oh,
I've seen pictures of her everywhere on social media.
Yeah.
So I don't know, like, what happened?
Is that people a wanted?
Yeah. If did people wanted her to be crowned or like what happened here? Let us know in the comments, please.
Let us know all the tea.
Yes.
Rabia Mateo. Good evening.
More questions.
How are you doing?
Yes.
I'm nervous. For everybody. Okay. So I will ask you 2 questions. You're able to choose a number backstage. After you talk for 30 seconds, you will hear this. And then I will ask another question where you receive another 30 seconds.
Ay, ay, ay.
2 questions now?
Here we go. Your first question. If you could create a new paper currency with the image of any Filipina on it, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
Ooh, this is a great question. Because
this is a fun question.
Yeah, it's fun and it's a great question because it reflects who she admires.
Yeah.
And who she thinks that is like so valuable for Filipino history that it should be.
In
on
the,
money,
yeah. What would you answer to this?
I had no
idea. They are alive.
All our national heroes are already on paper money. So, oh my God, I had to answer the question because you answered the first question.
Of course,
I would put Juan Bosch. I think Juan Bosch, like he added value to literature here in the Dominican Republic and also. His government, even though it was quick, it was one of the best government we have ever had. So I think that he deserves to be on paper money. He's going to answer.
If I were given the chance, I want to use the face of Miriam Defensor Santiago. For those who don't know, she was an Ilongga. But what I admired about her is that she used her knowledge, her voice to serve the country. And I want to be somebody like her, somebody who puts her heart, her passion into action. And after all, she is the best president that we never had.
Wow.
It was a female president?
Yes.
There was a female president in Philippines? I didn't know.
Me neither.
We have never had a female president.
Yes.
Okay. It's Shame. Time for your second question. This pandemic has made clear our priorities, essential or non-essential. Where do pageants stand in this time of crisis?
Ooh. Okay. Let's see what she says.
As a candidate, I know I'm not just the face of Iloilo City, but I am here carrying hope and as a symbol of light in the darkest times. And as of the moment, I want to help my community. I want to use my strength to make an impact. And that is the essence of beauty pageant. It gives us the power to make a difference.
Wow. Well, that was beautiful.
That was beautiful. Oh my God, the coronation! I'm so nervous. I know she wins, but it was against who? Paraña, okay. No, I don't know. The city started with Para. Oh, she was gorgeous as well.
Yes, Parañaque.
Oh yeah.
Miss Universe Philippines 2020.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Wow, Parañaque is tall.
Yes.
He's tall and super elegant as well. So I guess it was the answers to the questions that determined this, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, her smile is so beautiful.
Wow. Ooh, Parañaque looks like a villain so from confident. A soap opera, from a telenovela, like. She's like the protagonist, and she's like, huh, I am not going to be defeated.
Sorry, Parañaque.
Oh my God, what's wrong with Parañaque? I don't know. Look at this, like, she was looking at her and like, smiling and like, I'm reassuring her, right? And Parañaque is like,
Oh my God. Well, maybe Parañaque has a resting bitch face or something.
This is not resting bitch face.
Maybe that's not
her
intention.
She smiled like.
Maybe it's not her intention. Like, I understand.
Iloilo!
Yeah. Wow, they didn't even hook up because this is
a pandemic!
This is the social distancing version. Okay, sorry. The new crown is gorgeous.
Wow. And it has the colors of the Philippines flag.
Yeah. That's super expensive.
It feels a little bit odd without audience and people like showing the flag and being proud and
Yeah, it's odd.
But, you know, that's the way. Aww. She's so cute. That's the best we can do in the middle of the pandemic, and she's still doing this to nobody, literally.
So yeah, that was Rabia Mateo for you guys. She's awesome, and I think she's going.
I think it was well deserved. I didn't see the pageant complete, but yes, I think it was well deserved.
I think she's going to represent the Philippines very well in the international pageant.
Yeah, definitely.
So, guys, you have a great contestant. And you know what also is super great? This video that appears right here, recommended to you by YouTube algorithm. So click on it right now.